So for class 8, today's second chapter in English reader is A Christmas Carol. Christmas means the birthday of Jesus Christ. On this day we celebrate his birthday. And carol means the hymn. The hymn or the religious song, folk songs that we sing during the Christmas. So let's see. This extract, this Christmas carol, this story, this is an extract. Okay, this is actually the name of the original novel or the story is A Christmas Carol. From there, a small gist or from small extract has been taken, written by Charles Dickens. So let's begin. Ebenezer Scrooge. Ebenezer Scrooge is a wealthy but cold-hearted miser. So he was a wealthy, rich person and cold-hearted. Cold-hearted means who don't have any emotion, unemotional. Miser. Miser means pinch penny. Okay, so he was a cold-hearted miser. On Christmas Eve, he refuses a Christmas dinner invitation from his nephew Fred. So on the day of Christmas Eve, he got a dinner invitation from his nephew Fred. He is rude to two elderly gentlemen who come to his house to collect money for the poor. So he did a very bad, he misbehaved with the two elderly gentlemen who came to collect money for the poor. As we all know, during the Christmas, they used to give food, clothing to the poor people, poor children. He overworks his clerk, means he make his clerk, Bob Cratchit, work too much and is angry to give him a holiday on Christmas. Such a person is Ebenezer Scrooge that he did not want to give a holiday also during the Christmas. At night, the ghost of Scrooge's former partner means the partner who was there before, and the ghost means the spirit, Jack of Marley, who has dead for 7 years, visits him. So don't think this is a ghost story, but this is a really very interesting and humorous story. So here we will be seeing that Scrooge 7 years back dead friend, 7 years old dear friend who had dead, visits him, means comes to meet him, but in a different way, in a ghostly manner. He comes to warn Scrooge to mend his ways. Mend his ways means to improve himself, to make him correct. He tells Scrooge that three spirits will visit him, means three ghosts will come. One is Christmas past, another Christmas present, another Christmas yet to come, means the ghost of Christmas past, Christmas present and Christmas yet to come, means future. Appear and point out to Scrooge how cruel and bitter he has become. So they will come and they will show him that how bad he is now. Scrooge realizes his mistake. Now he understood his mistake, and then he decided to change his way, to change his thought, to change his word. So, see, what's today? Cried Scrooge, calling down to a boy in Sunday clothes, who perhaps had loitered in to look about him. Eh, returned the boy with all his might of wonder. What's today? Cried Scrooge. Scrooge is crying, means shouting, like, what is today? Calling down to a boy in Sunday clothes. So there was a boy who was in Sunday clothes, means he was wearing, Sunday means their prayer day. In for Christians, Sunday is the prayer day, so he called him that, what is today? Okay, who perhaps had loitered in to look about him. Loitered means to stand or wait around without any purpose. Okay, so he was just waiting or standing there without any purpose. Hey, return the boy. So Scrooge asks, hey, return the boy. With all his might of wonder, means he just gets shocked that he was been called by Ebenezer Scrooge. What's today, my fine fellow? Said Scrooge. Scrooge again asked, what is today?
Today
replied the boy. Why? Christmas Day. So the boy told that today is the Christmas Day. It's Christmas Day, said Scrooge to himself. So Scrooge is telling to himself, oh, today is Christmas. I haven't missed it. Means he is thankful that he hadn't missed the Christmas till now. The spirits have done it all in one night. So the previous night that spirits came and did all the work. They can do anything they like. The spirits could do anything because they are not human beings. Of course they can. Of course they can. Hello, my fine fellow. So this is the thought going on in the mind of Ebenezer Scrooge. He is thinking that yes, the ghost can do anything. After thinking so much, he again called out the boy. Hello, returned the boy. So the boy returned back. Do you know the poulterers in the next street but one? At the corner, Scrooge inquired. So Scrooge asked that, do you know the poulterer? Poulterer means those who sell chickens, poultries and all. So do you know him in the next street? That means the poulterer is in the next street but at the corner. I should hope I did, replied the lad. Lad means the boy. So the boy told, yes, I should, means I'm hoping that I will. An intelligent boy, said Scrooge, a remarkable boy. Do you know whether they have sold the prize turkey that was hanging up there? Not the little prize turkey, the big one. So Scrooge thought, wow, that is a very intelligent boy, a remarkable boy. Remarkable means extraordinary boy. So after thinking a lot, then he asked him that, do you know that the prize turkey, turkey is a type of hen. So the turkey, prize turkey that was hanging there has been sold or not? Not the little prize turkey, the big one. So the Scrooge explained him all the description of the turkey, and he told that not the little one, I'm talking about the big turkey. What? The one as big as me, returned the boy. So the boy was very humorous. He told, what? Oh, the turkey which is big like me. What a delightful boy, said Scrooge. Scrooge thought that he is a very cheerful boy. It's a pleasure to talk to him. Yes, my buck. Buck means a male horned rhino. Okay. So now Scrooge become very happy. So he is telling that, I'm very happy to talk to you. It's hanging there now, replied the boy. So the boy told, yes, yes, it is still now there. Is it? Said Scrooge. Go and buy it. So Scrooge asked that, okay, then it is there, then please go and buy it. Walk here, exclaimed the boy. Will I walk? No, no, said Scrooge. I'm in earnest. Go and buy it and tell them to bring it here, that I may give them the direction where to take it. So now Scrooge told, no, no, I'm very serious. You just go and tell them to bring it here. Then I will tell them that where they have to take it, in which place. Come back with the man and I will give you a shilling. Come back with him in less than 5 minutes and I will give you half a crown. The boy was off like a shot. So to make him little bit of indulge in the work, he told that if you come with the man, then I will give you a shilling. Shilling is a former British coin. Okay. Again, he told that it's a condition. If you come within less than 5 minutes, I will give half a crown. Half a crown is British coin, but that is more than shilling. After listening that, the boy just went from there like a shot of the gun. Means he will get a half a crown or a shilling. That is just a remarkable thing for him on the day of Christmas. I will send it to Bob Cratchit's. He shan't know who sends it. It's twice the size of Tiny Tim. Joe Miller never made such a joke as sending it to Bob's will be. So Scrooge is thinking that I will send this to Bob Cratchit and he shouldn't know about it, that I have sent it. That one will be twice the size of Tiny Tim. Tiny Tim is the son of Bob Cratchit. Joe Miller never made such a joke. Joe Miller has never made a joke as sending it to Bob's will be. Scrooge wrote down the address on a piece of paper and went downstairs to open the street door, ready for the arrival of the poulterer's man. Now, Scrooge had written down the address of Bob Cratchit on a piece of paper and he went downstairs to open the street door. And he was waiting for the poulterer's man. Here's the turkey. Hello, woof, how are you? Merry Christmas. So now at that moment, the poulterer came and he, with an excitement, joy and excitement, he told that, yes, your turkey. How are you, Mr. Scrooge? Merry Christmas. So today up to here, next day I will continue.